Welcome to Fat Over 40. My name's Miles, and in this episode, we're going to look at my supplements. Now, if you're new to the channel, please subscribe. There's a new film every single Friday, and if you like what you hear, then please give us a big fat thumbs up. But more importantly, get involved and comment down below. Let me know what you think. Let me know what supplements you're taking that maybe I'm not. Now, when I first started my journey, for all of my adult life, I've never taken any supplements at all. Well, that's not surprising considering I was so unhealthy. But as I sort of got into my journey and discovered that I needed to sort of be supplementing some of the things in my diet since I had my heart surgery, obviously there are other things that I needed to incorporate to keep myself nice and fit and healthy. And also as I started to sort of train, there were things that I needed to incorporate into my diet to help with sort of muscle repair and recovery and that sort of stuff. So I'm just going to run through all of the supplements that I take on a daily basis and some of the sort of other things that I also use. So the first thing that you can see here is fish oils, omega-3s. I take sort of two different types. One is a general sort of high concentrate of omega-3 fish oil, and the other one is krill oil. Krill, they're little sort of crustaceans, little tiny little things, but they're packed full of omega-3s. So I take those on a daily basis. They're really good for your heart. And as I, as you well know, I had some heart issues a couple of years ago. So I take these to keep everything going and to help with my healthy heart. Now, in the winter time, I take a vitamin D pill. This is really important for your immune system and for sort of healthy bones and muscles. In the summer, it's not so important if you're outside and getting lots of sunshine, but if you are stuck in an office and you don't sort of see the sun on a daily basis, then you continue to take your vitamin D. You can OD on vitamin D, not sort of OD, but you can have too much, so you need to sort of watch your levels, especially if you live in a sunny country, I suppose. I also take milk thistle. This has been proven to have sort of good cleansing abilities for your liver. So if you're sort of going out drinking heavily, taking a couple of milk thistle tablets can sort of help process it all. But I have suffered from fatty liver disease, non-alcoholic fatty liver disease. So I take this to try and sort of cleanse my liver through. And I'm hoping that over a number of years, I can actually reverse the damage that I've done to my liver in terms of clogging it up with fats over the years. So that's the milk thistle. We're currently trying for a family, so I do take a fertility pill. That sounds weird. It's like a multivitamins pill, and it's specific for men's fertility. So it's no surprise that it's got all the stuff I need in there to make sure that I've got healthy, strong swimmers. Just sounds weird, doesn't it? The other thing that I take, and I've been taking more of since I've been working out and sort of getting educated about fitness, is essential amino acids, or branch chain amino acids, or BCAAs for short. You may well have heard of these. So the tablets that I take on a daily basis have got all eight of the essential amino acids in there, which helps with muscle recovery and muscle growth for healthy muscles. I also take BCAAs in a powder form, and I add that to my water when I take my water bottle to do my exercising. And that'll also help to, if I'm doing a long exercise, not to break down my muscles too much. It'll help with that repair and recovery process. So those are the sort of pills that I take of a morning. At night, I take something called ZMA. Now, I haven't been doing this for very long. It's only been about a month. ZMA is zinc, magnesium, and aspartate. And this helps with, again, recovery, muscle recovery, especially through the night when you're sleeping. And when you're sleeping, that's when your body's repairing itself the most as well. But it's been really helping me with my sleep. Especially the quality of the sleep I've been getting. So every night I take three ZMA tablets about an hour before I go to bed, and I've been finding that I haven't been waking up so many times throughout the night, and I have been getting sort of a better, deeper, better quality sleep. I mean, whether it's the placebo effect, I don't know. But look, it seems to be working so far, so I'm going to keep on going with the ZOA at night. Excuse me. The other things that I incorporate into my diet is a whey protein. So this is your typical sort of protein shake that you see everyone walking around shaking their shakers. Oh dear, someone's going to Photoshop that action, aren't they? We're putting something in it. But look, I resisted the whole protein shake thing for probably about a year. The first year of my training, I was like, no, I'm not getting involved with the whole protein shake thing. And again, the more educated I got involved with it. And, you know, it's now a staple part of what I do pretty much on a daily basis. So with a protein shake, with this particular protein shake, I get on with it really well. It's not got sort of all of, it's not got any sort of bulking agents within it. And it's pretty good, and it does its job for me. Now, of a morning, if I'm training really early in the morning, sort of 5-6 o'clock in the morning, I don't really feel like having a breakfast before that, and I'm pretty much getting up and getting myself straight to the gym within about 15 minutes of waking up. So I'll take a shake then and get that down me to give me a little bit of energy for my exercise. But more commonly, I'll take a protein shake after I've exercised to help, again, replenish my energy levels and keep me going. Now, these two things here, reds and greens, these are things that I add to a shake, even to my protein shake. It's quite obvious what's in them. In the reds, it's mainly fruits, so you're getting a really high concentration of all your vitamins and minerals that you'd normally get from fruits, with the fruits and berries within the reds. And within the greens, as the name would suggest, it's all of the sort of green stuff. So, you know, your kale, your spinach, and all your sort of your green veg. And again, high concentrations of the vitamins and minerals. And they taste pretty good. So, again, it's another sort of thing that you can supplement into your diet to make sure you're getting all of the proper nutrients. From time to time, I do use a pre-workout. To be honest with you, I use it sparingly. This stuff is is like drugs. It's generally got like a load of caffeine in it, and whenever I take it, my lips go all tingly and you sort of get a little bit jittery. But I only take it when I'm looking to do like a maximum lift, or if I'm really, really tired and I need a proper pick-me-up. It's definitely not something that I would subscribe to taking every single time you go to the gym. Although I do know some people that do, and they walk around with looking like they've smoked lots of spliffs with their big red bloodshot eyes, which doesn't make me chuckle. Anyway, so that's my experience of pre-workouts. So I think that sort of sums up everything that I take to supplement my diet. So this shot here, this is the quantity of actual pills that I shove into my mouth with my lemon water first thing in the morning. It looks like a lot, but to be honest with you, you just get on with it and get it going. I know perhaps there's a lot of stuff out there as to whether supplements work or they don't, or whether the stomach acid breaks all this stuff down and it never gets into your system. No. My experience so far is that these things have been working for me. I can't tell you that, you know, I've got fitter and healthier and I look younger and I've lost weight because of these things. But look, I'm taking them as part of a well-rounded diet, and I think they're helping me. So that's all that matters, I suppose. Now, we have got the biggest Get Healthy collab coming back at you for our first quarter update and review. There's now 20 odd people in the collab, so it's good fun. And if you haven't already, then check out the description box below and you can find out exactly who's in the collaboration. But come April the 1st, we will be, you know, April Fool's Day, we will be releasing a video every day, which involves us all, yeah? And part of that process is our quarterly review update. So you'll be finding out whether or not we have hit our goals that we set for ourselves in January. I've got like a week left. I need to get on and I need to hit those goals. So if you haven't seen the goals video, then click here. If you haven't seen the lazy bum video with the lovely Jess, then click here. And if you haven't subscribed, what are you waiting for? Click here. And if you make one change this week, think about supplements so you don't die fat.